Hey viewers, welcome to Ultimate Guide, and today I'm going to give you a beginner's guide on Fortran in short. So let's begin, let's dig in. So first of all, we'll have to know what is Fortran. Fortran is an abbreviated form of formula translation. It was created in 1957 by John Backes, and it's a computer programming language suited to numeric computation and scientific computing. If you want to know more about the history of Fortran, I'll give you a link in the description of this video. Now, let's look at Fortran constant and variable. We use two types of Fortran constant. One is integer constant and the other is real constant. So, what is integer constant? Integer constants are the whole numbers which don't have a decimal part. For example, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 or any whole number. It can be 0, positive or negative. On the other hand, the real constants are those which have a decimal part. For example, 2.47 or 0.123 or 8.9786, etc. And it can also be positive, negative or 0. Now, let's look at Fortran variables. As like as Fortran constant, there are two types of Fortran variables which we mainly use. And these are integer variable and real variable. An integer variable must begin with these letters, which are I, J, K, L, M, and N. Now let's look at the real variable. A real variable must begin with the letters from A to H and from O to Z. In short, except the six integer variables, which are I, J, K, L, M, and N. In Fortran 77 or 90, these variables must not exceed 6 characters. But here, in this software, you can use more than 6 characters to form an integer variable or real variable. Now let's look at this software. In this portion, we won't write our program. We will use it for commenting or continuation of program. So where will we write our program? We'll write it in between this portion. And what about this remaining portion? Here, whatever we will write will be non-executable. Now, let's write a program. How to find the sum of the numbers from 1 to 10? We will write C program to find the sum of the numbers from 1 to 10. Here, C stands for comment. But you can use hashtag or exclamation mark also. As the numbers from 1 to 10 are all integers, so our output will also be an integer. So let's take our output as total and the number of terms as n. So we will write integer n, total. Here you can notice one thing. Total, it starts with t, which is a real variable. But here we are declaring it as an integer variable, so it will act as like as an integer variable. Now we will write print star comma inverted comma, and we will write how many terms inverted comma close. Here the statement print star comma will display the sentence that we have written within the inverted commas. Now we will write read star comma n. Here read star comma means we are expecting some values from the user that will be entered from the keyboard. Now we will write total is equal to n asterisk n plus 1 within parentheses slash 2. Here asterisk represent multiplication and slash represent division. N asterisk n plus 1 within parentheses slash 2. It's a formula to get the sum of consecutive and finite numbers. Now we will again write print star comma inverted comma. The sum of the numbers is inverted comma close comma total. Now the program is almost complete. We will just have to write stop and end. Now you are done. So let's run our program and see. Here you can click on this green button or you can use F9 from your keyboard to run this program. So oops, it didn't work because currently I'm using 64 bit of Windows 10 and it's a 32 bit program. So don't worry, all you'll have to do is just write a pause here and now it will surely run. Yeah, now you can see it's asking how many jumps. We will give 10 from the keyboard because we're trying to print the sum of the numbers from 1 to 10. And now press enter. So you can see the result. The sum of the numbers is 55. So that's it. If you're having any technology related problem, then please don't hesitate to ask. Thank you for watching this video. If you like this video, then hit the like button, comment, share, and subscribe. We really need your support.